Good. Fixing the hair. Got to be beautiful. Yeah, that's me. Beautiful. Good morning. Today we are going to learn about the Biot-Savart Law.
Flippin' physics.
It is named after the two French scientists who experimentally determined this law. That's right. The equation I'm about to show you cannot be mathematically derived. Instead, it was experimentally determined. The Biot-Savart Law, and again, these words are French, these names are French, and I'm going to do my best to say them, but honestly, I'm not that great at French pronunciation, and I'm sorry. I'm doing my best. The Biot-Savart Law gives the magnitude and direction of an infinitesimally small magnetic field dB caused by the current passing through an infinitesimally small portion of a wire. The equation is the infinitesimally small magnetic field dB equals mu naught, the magnetic permeability of free space, divided by the quantity 4 pi, all times the cross product of the current in the wire times the length of an infinitesimally small portion of the wire, dl, and unit vector r, all divided by the square of the distance r. Unit vector r points from the location of the infinitesimally small length of the wire, dl, to the location of the infinitesimally small magnetic field, dB. R is the magnitude of the distance between those two points. And the magnetic permeability of free space is a constant equal to 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7 teslas times meters over amps. Again, this equation shows that a current-carrying wire creates a magnetic field. In fact, because current is composed of individually moving electric charges, even a single moving electric charge causes a magnetic field. All right, let's talk about the direction of the magnetic field caused by a current-carrying wire. Clearly, the Biot-Savart Law, which uses the cross product, gives the direction of the magnetic field. Class, what handy tool do we use to determine the direction of the cross product?
The right-hand rule.
Of course.
Don't be too cool.
Limber up.
And find your right hand.
Here we go. Fingers point in the direction of current or of the wire. Fingers curl in the direction of unit vector r. It is a good rule of thumb to start curling at 90 degrees.
Again, that's funny.
For conventional current, thumb points in the direction of the magnetic field. Let's do an example. We have a long straight wire with current to the right. Let's label a small portion of the wire dl. The direction of dl is in the direction of the current in the wire. And let's find the direction of the magnetic field at a location which is located a distance r from the wire, and r is at a 90 degree angle from the wire. Unit vector r points from dl to the location we are finding the magnetic field dB, which means it is also at a right angle to the wire. Using the right-hand rule, we get that, using our right hand, the fingers point to the right in the direction of the infinitesimal distance dl. Fingers curl in the direction of unit vector r. In this case, that means they curl 90 degrees downward. Thumb points into the screen, which means the infinitesimal magnetic field dB is into the screen at this location. The symbol we use for into the screen is an X.
We can remember that because we can picture an arrow moving away from us, and the X represents the fletching of the arrow as it moves away from us, even though an arrow actually only has 3 feathers.
Correct, Billy. Again, the Biot-Savart Law shows that a current-carrying wire creates a magnetic field, and for this small portion of the wire, with current to the right, the magnetic field is into the screen at this location below the wire. Bo, please determine the magnetic field at a new location above the wire, a distance r, again at a right angle to the wire.
Sure. Point our fingers to the right in the direction of dl, the infinitesimal distance along the wire in the direction of the current. Curl our fingers up in the direction of the unit vector, which points from dl to the location where we are determining the direction of the infinitesimal magnetic field dB. Our thumb points out of the screen, which is the direction of the magnetic field caused by the current in the wire. Oh, and we show out of the screen with a dot, which represents the tip of the arrow, which is coming at us.
That is correct. Thank you, Bo. Notice the direction of the magnetic field caused by an infinitesimally small portion of the current carrying wire, DL, is the same along a line parallel to the straight wire. In other words, when I move the location where we are finding the direction of the infinitesimal magnetic field, DB, to the right and parallel to the wire, we can use the same right-hand rule to show that the magnetic field is still out of the screen. We have just shown that along this line parallel to the wire, the magnetic field is always out of the screen above the wire. Bobby, what about the magnitude of the infinitesimally small magnetic field DB caused by the infinitesimally small portion of the wire DL as we move away from a point whose unit vector points at a right angle to the wire?
Okay, so as the location of DB moves to the right and causes the unit vector R to no longer be at a right angle to the wire, the distance r to the location of the magnetic field increases because the distance r is in the denominator of the Biot-Savart law. The magnitude of the magnetic field decreases as you get farther from a line perpendicular to the straight wire. Yeah, but the direction remains the same because the cross product of dl and unit vector r always gives the same direction. Yeah, the magnitude of dB decreases as the value of R, which is in the denominator of the equation, increases. That makes sense.
Thank you, Bobby. That is correct. Now, it is important to realize that this is for an infinitesimally small portion of the wire DL. However, there are, for an infinitely long, straight current-carrying wire, an infinite number of infinitesimally small portions of the wire DL. And all of their magnetic fields add up to cause the magnetic field to have a uniform value at a distance r straight out from the wire. We have shown that above and parallel to the wire, there exists a uniform magnetic field which is out of the screen. And below and parallel to the wire, there exists a uniform magnetic field which is into the screen. And the magnitude of the magnetic field created by the infinitesimally long straight current carrying wire also decreases as the distance r from the wire increases. Also, there is an alternate right-hand rule specifically for determining the direction of the magnetic field around a current carrying wire.
Alternate right-hand rule?
But I only have one right hand.
That does not seem right.
Does it seem left?
Right?
Yeah, I know. But trust me, it definitely makes it easier to determine the direction of the magnetic field around a current-carrying wire.
Okay.
Thumb of the right hand points in the direction of conventional current. Fingers of the right hand curl in the direction of the magnetic field, which surrounds and is caused by a current-carrying wire.
That is easier. I mean, using that for the example with the current in the wire to the right, you can see that the magnetic field is out of the screen above the wire and into the screen below the wire.
And if you look at the same wire from the side with the current coming directly at you or out of the screen, you can see the magnetic field is counterclockwise from that perspective because the thumb points out of the screen and the fingers curl counterclockwise. And from that perspective, you can also see the magnetic field, the magnitude of the magnetic field decreasing as we get farther from the infinitely long straight current carrying wire.
And if you turn the wire 180 degrees and have the current going into the screen, the thumb points into the screen and the fingers curl clockwise from this perspective, showing the direction of the magnetic field around the wire from that perspective. Thanks for the alternate right-hand rule for the magnetic field around current-carrying wires, Mr. Pete.
Yeah, it actually does make it much easier.
You are welcome. Now, the Biot-Savart law can be used to determine the magnitude of the magnetic field a distance r from an infinitely long straight current-carrying wire. The magnetic field equals the magnetic permeability of free space times current, all divided by the quantity 2 pi times distance r. However, we are not going to do that derivation today.
Oh, man.
Okay. That's fine with me.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.